certified cicerone and host of What's on Tap Radio, Chad Pilbeam, is back here with all the details on your national holiday.
It's right. Every time I come on, you guys are always...
We're drinking beer. It's fantastic. And you guys got a jump start. I saw. You guys were drinking earlier.
We had cocktails first.
Okay. All right. Fantastic.
Just a light cocktail. But, Chad, you really are the master when it comes to this. I don't know how you go on the radio and just talk about beer for hours and hours and hours at a time. Apparently, there's a lot to say.
There is. There's a lot happening in the world of beer. And today is... German Beer Day, but before we get started, I thought we would do something a little fun.
Okay.
Okay. I'll tell you a little bit about German Beer Day, but there's a contest called Steinhoisting, or also known as Maßkrugstemmen.
Yeah.
Where you hold out your Stein like this. I thought maybe while I describe this, and normally I put beer in here, I would do that for you, but I don't want you to spill. So why don't you just go ahead and take that one there?
Oh, terror.
Yep. And here you go, Courtney.
Can we switch arms?
And no, you cannot. And so the idea, and you hold it out straight just like that. Okay. And while I tell you about German Beer Day, don't bend your elbow. And by the way, the world record is 21 minutes. I'll be happy if you can make it about three.
Because you're 21 minutes.
Yeah, your arm starts to burn after a little while.
Lori could do it in 21 minutes.
I know. Can I switch off? Can I tag?
Orders. My goodness.
Can I tag?
Can we find a friend?
No, you cannot. Yes. So just let me know. By the way, we did. So that right there is a Maß or a Maßkrug. Maß meaning 1 liter. Krug is the type of glass that you have there. So a Maßkrug, 1 liter glass.
I'm already shaking.
I see the shaking going on there. It's a little bit heavy, and so this is an actual competition that they hold, the Bavarian Strongman.
I have no idea what you're even talking about. I'm not hearing the word.
Yes, it's a little bit of a challenge to try and pay attention and keep your arm straight without spilling any beer, but the idea is you got to keep your elbows straight and you got to hold it up.
It would be a lot easier if I could just be distracted.
Yeah. Oh, okay, then watch this. See, I already poured you a beer.
What is this?
That is a Pilsner for you.
Cheers.
And I have a Schwarz beer for you, a Schwarz beer being a dark lager. So you have a black lager right there. And so, yeah, so now you guys are
double fisting to a whole new level.
Right, and so you are...
I am so annoyed right now. I'm kidding.
Yeah, that's right. This is the last time I get invited back.
No, okay.
You gave me an exercise. This is ridiculous.
Wait, so why is National German Beer Day celebrated then?
Well, so the Bavarian Purity Law of 1516, on this day in 1516 in Germany or Bavaria, they signed a law that said you could only make beer with barley, hops, and water. And that ensured the quality of the beer that was being made. You holding on? All right, she's done. All right, so congratulations, Derek. You have won the very first.
Good job.
You have won the very first Houston Life Maßkrugstemmen.
I was digging my nails into my hand.
You know, probably would have been a little bit nicer if I'd given you the half liter.
Well, now you tell me.
I know, we could have done that.
It really is harder than it looks.
It is. It is brutal. But now, your reward, you get to drink beer.
Good job.
Yes, fantastic.
Okay, let's talk about some of the other.
What are we talking about?
So German Beer Day, when the Bavarian Purity Law went into effect, also known as the Reinheitsgebot. Yeah, say that three times really fast.
Reinheitsgebot. Reinheitsgebot.
Is that a guy?
Well done. Okay.
Is that a bad word, by the way?
It's not. It's actually inspired the American craft beer movement because it said, hey, it got associated with quality because we're only going to put in barley, hops, yeast, and water. And since that was the purity law, it said, this is all we're going to put in. We're not going to put in any fake sugars or any additives or preservatives. We're just going to make real, honest beer. And that's what craft brewers wanted to do for a long time. They want to say, hey, let's make something that's different than all the beer that's coming out of factories. And has all the preservatives and foam stabilizers and said, no, we're not going to do it. And so we've got commercial examples here from Germany. And then we also have just some samples here, some examples of American craft beer that was inspired by those styles. And so that's really what German Beer Day is. It celebrates the Reinheitsgebot, which says, hey, you know what? This is all about quality beer.
And there's all different, basically, levels, right? From light to dark.
Right. Exactly. So it's just like your American craft beer movement starts off Pilsner beer, for example. Pilsner beer, which, for example, we do have this one right down here. I'm going to go ahead and pick this one up and show you here. This is a German Pilsner right here, Bitburger. This right here, this style inspired most of the big name beers that your grandpa drank and your dad drank, you know, BMC, Bud Miller Coors, all Pilsner style beers. And so this Pilsner right here, this is exactly what inspired those types of things. And as far as the American beer movement, as far as where we came from and how we evolved, it all started with everybody drinking a nice, easy, crisp lager like that.
Chad, let me ask you, we're less than a minute, by the way, left in the segment.
Oh, wow.
If you're on your way to a pool party and you know your friend is a beer snob or they really love craft beer, what do you buy? Because they're like now,
even
at a grocery store, there are so many to choose from.
I like, we've got a beautiful variety up here. We have something nice and malty, like a Bock beer. You go Bock beer, you don't have to worry about somebody who doesn't like bitter beer. And so it's got nice malt flavor. As I explained, nice easy drinking beer down there with the Pilsner. But right here, this is always a fun one, a Radler. This is a blend between wheat beer and a carbonated soda. And actually, Radler literally means cycler's beer. So that's what it stands for.
Nice.
And so really nice beer, really refreshing. By the way, just a little fun fact for you. In a wheat beer, you ever see the little orange wedge on the side?
Yeah.
Don't do it. Don't do this at home. Pay attention right here. Never put the orange wedge on there because all that citric acid kills the beautiful head in your beer.
We got to leave it there, Chad. For more info on What's on Tap Radio, visit our website, HoustonLife.tv.